This particular lockup has turned into something of a wood store at the moment. I blagged a whole load of wood and board for different projects in the big house refurbishment. So they're in here keeping dry. So some of the bikes have been rather shoved over. I need to get this done. Well, actually just wheels put back in it and a bit of a clean up and it's fine. Lovely Pashley tandem. I won't show you the rest of it because I'm going to do a video. Right. This is an interesting thing. This week's mystery object is... it's the tow hitch for a 1950s thereabouts trailer. And the trailer is there with a lighter aluminium body on it. So that is going to be refurbished and be a vintage trailer to be pulled by the old roadsters. This is what I've come in here for. This is a 80s, mid 80s, maybe late 80s courier, Raleigh Courier, in quite a small frame size, 21 inch, something like that. Still got some of the original graphics, which wear off as soon as you touch them with a polishing cloth. Decent condition. Been dismantled by myself for storage, really. That's a curiosity of the Courier. That bracket, there is a braze on inside of the seat stay. And it's the dynamo bracket for the optional dynamo, which this one obviously had. So that'll probably be removed. That's going to be built up. Someone's expressed an interest. It's in the queue to be built up, so it's going to come to the front of the queue as soon as I've finished the ones I'm doing, and that's going to be built up for its new owner. And then if the new owner changes their mind in the meantime, I'll advertise it for sale. Going to be the next week or two that it will be done and on the road, and then we've got to dive back into here to find some more of the tinware and such like for it. Now, what have we got here? What we have here is, I'll just stick it against the back of the car, a Raleigh Richmond. Nice 531. Well finished, well turned out touring bike. Somebody's messed about a little bit with it, putting these arrangement of thumb shifters. That'll be seen to. I think it's probably had stem shifters on originally because it's already got the double cable stop on here. So it's probably had stem shifters on. I will fit either stem shifters or some down tube shifters to this. Quite a small frame, so down tube shifters will be fine. And the rider's hands will be fairly well to hand. And it'll be the Raleigh branded Wainman brakes. Yes, it is. Centre pulls. The Raleigh pattern rear rack in horrible rusty chrome, that'll be coming off, and I'll put a lightweight Blackburn or something like that on there. That can be saved for something else. It can be rubbed down, primed and painted the colour of a bicycle, a roadster or something. In fact, I have a bike in mind. Otherwise, all you fairly basic. Oh, is that Biopace? Yes, it is. Shimano Biopace chain rings. Now, do I leave them or do they go? Do they stay or do they go? Don't know, I'll have to work that one out. So that's a nice, quite small Raleigh Richmond for somebody when I've refurbished it. I actually bought it from a guy called Richmond. I guess that's probably why he had it, because the bike didn't fit him. I'll stick it with these projects here. This is something else to be dragged out of the back of the car. This is a Lady Superbe, which unfortunately is a donor bike. It's already had some bits taken off. The wheel's obviously taken out. It's got blue, presumably Wayfarer mudguards on, which are quite shabby. The chain case is straight though, rusty but straight. and I've already got some pieces off it, as you can see. So there's not much left to take off, clips and things like that. And then I'm afraid that's the end for that one. Here's an interesting project bike. Not the sort of thing I normally would have bought, but it's just so unusual. I love the colour combination. It's ridiculous and very of its time. Crown Star. Never heard of it, but it's Crown Cycles. I looked it up on Classic Lightweights, and sure enough, there are some examples, but pretty rare. And someone's loved this bike. Someone has definitely loved it. They've added these horrible, horrible early mountain bike bullhorn handlebars. Obviously they will be coming off. I've got a set of period drops. I've got some red tape. Or I might even put North Roads on if I can find some nice red grips. But at the moment it's scheduled for drops with red tape. These, I don't know, maybe the retro mountain bike people might like them. Very late 80s, early 90s. Other than that, it's pretty much as it's always been. Nice Mafex centre pulls and Nervex professional lugs, which haven't really been filed to any great degree, but and I would say that paint's a bit thin as well. I wouldn't have been happy doing that paint job myself, but it's the original factory paint. So it'll be left on, patina and all. Not sure about the white cables, might change those for blacks. And what's the crank set? Maxi with a Y, so nothing to do with Maxi car hubs or Maxi hubs from France. And the rear, nice, early Shimano 600. And the mech is a Thunderbird 2. If only I could remember the theme tune. Still, you've been spared that. Nice looking pedals. Everything is just dull and neglected. So, just the sort of bike for a project. That's going to be nice. Out of the ordinary for my usual thing. And of course, I did mention, didn't I? No, I didn't. That it's 531 main tubes. So there we have a Crown Star. And here's another one. I got this at the same time as the Crown Star. Another period delight in very original condition. And it is a Motobecane Grand Sport. Equipment on this one. Oh dear, there go the girls again. Equipment on this one, very basic. So I'm going to upgrade everything. It's just got steel everything, apart from the Atax stem. So I shall leave that stem, and anything that's steel will be upgraded to alloy. No doubt it's got some Hura Elvit mech. Yeah. Here on the front, Salida steel crankset with cotters. That can actually be used on something else. So it'll get a square taper bottom bracket. It deserves decent components now. Maybe in its day it was the cheap model, but it deserves some decent components. I like the stainless steel randonneur mud guards. They might stay on, or I might use them on something else. I can see this bike maybe being stripped down a bit, not having the carrier and mudguards, and just being a bit more road bikey for some hipster to tool around Manchester on. What's the tubing? One better than gas pipe, basically. So nothing much to shout about. I just love the style, I love the colour, the graphics. It's an aesthetes bike, this one. Yeah, it'll be nice. I'm going to enjoy doing this one when I eventually get round to it, which may be sometime. Just a nice old typical 1980s, 90s probably, looking at the graphics. Gazelle that could be from the 1920s. Yeah, it's 90s. It's had the plastic headlamp, the bracket that conceals the top of the headset, and a rod operated drum brakes, which will be linked, these rods probably, yes. So you pull one rod and it pulls both rods, and you set the timings on them so that the front brake operates just slightly after the rear brake, or is it before? I can't remember. Anyway, you set them up like a motorcycle, and it's supposed to be an anti-skid facility, but more I think is so that you can ride the bike one-handed when you're carrying your shopping or whatever else you're doing. You know, the Dutch are always doing something else. Cycling is always the third thing on the list of things to do while riding a bicycle or a Dutch person. So I'm not going to restore it like this. This is going to be something a little bit different. I've got two or three things in mind. Let's see what it turns out. I think everyone I know in this hobby, and certainly back in the days when I was into vintage and classic cars actively, I still like them, but I call myself an interested, enthusiastic observer now. Yeah, everyone in these hobbies, we all dream, don't we, of having a place with a huge barn. I have my workshop, and I have the storage, the bricks and mortar storage, which I don't really like putting the outside of on the internet. So it's only really when I'm down at this little lockup that I show you anything. But yes, the penalty of not being able to afford a farm or something, or an complex of industrial units like I used to have in York for bike rescue, is that so much of your time is always spent going back and forth and back and forth. So I need either a cargo bike or a bike with a trailer big enough to transport other bikes on, which again is what I used to have when I was doing it more or less full time. So maybe I need to go back to that. Or you need a motor vehicle of some description, and I'd rather not be going backwards and forwards in the car. I'd really rather not. I don't like using a car in town, even though our towns and this suburban sprawl where we are at the moment are kind of designed around the car, geared up for the car, and make it difficult to do without one. I'd still much rather not have to, either be on course on something. That's it. I'd much rather cycle everywhere, and I do cycle when I'm not having to hold bicycles around. Now, I'd like to take Sir Claude home, but really there's not room. So you'll have to stay here for the moment. There we are. Whew, and then I turn around, there's always one more thing. Oh look, the huge bike boxes. I keep a stash of bike boxes for selling bikes online and shipping them. And the local, excuse the cardboard for a moment while I lift this. Local bike shops are usually only too pleased to give these away. So if you do have a bike to send somewhere, hello Paul, that's the way to do it. Go to your local bike shop and they'll be only too pleased to get rid of one. Right, now lift these in, which needs both hands, and get on my way, having just said hello to my garage neighbour. Right, so that's that. The last thing to go in being a pile of cardboard boxes, which I keep. For sending bikes away to people.